بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Dear brothers and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We continue with سورة الأعلى, the surah number 87, and the name of the surah is الأعلى, the most high, Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And we start today with verse 16. بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا. And verse 17. والآخرة خير وأبقى. But those two verses talk about something that is very important. And that is, what is this life in compared to the hereafter? And how do we favor, and why do we favor this life over the hereafter? Where the hereafter is the everlasting one, and this dunya and this life is the short-lived one. So this world is worthless in comparison to the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in this verse, verse 16, بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. Rather you prefer. يُؤْثِرُ or تُؤْثِرُ or يُؤْثِرُ, it means you prefer, you favor الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا, the life of this world. بَلْ تُؤْثِرُونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. Rather you prefer the life of this world. Rather you favor the life of this world. You give it precedence over the matter of the hereafter, and you prefer it because of what it contains of pleasures and benefits in our dunya, in terms of money, wealth, and the pleasures of the dunya. But Allah is telling us, this is not the thing that we should prefer. We should prefer the hereafter and make our goals for the hereafter more than it is for the dunya. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in many, many places that this is not what you should favor. You should favor the hereafter, because the hereafter is everlasting. The hereafter is the one that you will live eternally. And that's the one that you should do your best so you can enjoy that eternal life with paradise. And that means you should not make your dunya as a priority. You should not let dunya take you away from worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Many examples in Surah At-Takathur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرُ. Multiplying things of wealth or of whatever worldly pleasures, that taken you away all the way till you reached your graves. In other words, you spend all your life doing things that take you away from the worshipping in Allah, and you get so occupied, so busy, and you favor this dunya over the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us in Surah Al-Qiyamah, the surah number is 75, and the verses of Surah Al-Qiyamah, two verses, one is 20 and the other one is 21. كَلَّا بَلْ تُحِبُّونَ الْعَاجِلَةِ وَتَذَرُونَ الْآخِرَةِ. Nay, but you love the present life of this world and neglect the hereafter. The nafs like what it can see, and that is the dunya and the worldly pleasures. But that should not be the case. The case that we should love the akhirah and work for the akhirah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in a hadith that is mentioned in Imam Ahmad, and where من أحب دنياه أضر بآخرته ومن أحب آخرته أضر بدنياه فآثر ما يبقى على ما يفنى. Whomever loves this worldly life will suffer in the hereafter, and whoever loves his hereafter will suffer in his worldly life. Therefore choose or favor that which is everlasting over that which is temporary. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us seek the hereafter in everything we do. And everything that Allah gives us, we have to always consider the hereafter is our goal, and yet to be also balancing this with the worldly things that we need to survive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Qasas, وَابْتَغِي فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةِ وَلَا تَنْسَ نَصِيبَكَ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا. Seek in what Allah has given you the hereafter. If Allah gives you wealth, use it to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if Allah gives you health, use that good health in worshipping in Allah and in performing the ibadat that Allah has put on you. So whatever Allah has given you, seek the hereafter, seek the pleasure of Allah, seek following the commands of Allah, and try to avoid the prohibitions of Allah. And لا تنسى نصيبك من الدنيا, and don't forget what your share of this dunya. We have a duty in this dunya, we have a mission in this dunya, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to do our parts. وَسْعُوا فِي مَنَاكِبِهَا وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِهِ. And you strive and work on this earth and seek His rizq. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best understanding of this Qur'an and give us the benefit of this Qur'an and the benefit of the teaching of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله سبحانك ربنا وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.